We're back, top of the hour, the Rick and Bubba show.
Good gosh, your mighty, she looks so fine. She's the best girl that I've ever had, but sometimes she sure makes me feel so bad. Na, na, na,
na, na, na. We're back as the classic Hush. Tim Wilson joins us this morning. Timmy, welcome back to the program.
Tim,
comedian,
sir.
Songwriter extraordinaire, Timmy Wilson.
Good morning. Well, Bubba, how come you never pass out when I'm here?
Well, you know, we try to limit that to one ratings book.
Somebody told me that you bit the carpet dirt or whatever it is.
Well, not completely. Technically, it was a gray out.
Yeah, it was a gray out. Bubba's still claiming he did. The lights should not completely go down in the
theater. Yeah, it was black and white, and the screen was getting dim, but it didn't go out.
I'm telling you
now
this.
I could hear Rick saying, hey, buddy, you all right? In my mind, I was answering him, but my mouth wasn't moving.
Let me tell you something, Bubba. I've been around show business quite a while, and I realize that once people get on TV, they have a tendency to change. Okay? Rick hasn't changed at all. He looks exactly the same as he did when y'all weren't even syndicated, when y'all were straight out of Oxford, Alabama. He looks the exact same. He almost looks like he did when he was in high school going out there to play for his daddy.
And?
You... I don't even recognize you anymore.
Oh, come on.
Let's get over here and look at some of these pictures. Let's get the pictures out over here.
I remember when
Bubba had an Anniston, Alabama haircut? one of them helmet head thing with a mustache. And
yeah, sure.
Looked like he'd, you know, been working at a Hardee's or something, shift.
Sure.
You know.
Well, the mustache comes and goes. It depends.
A miscut
and it has to leave.
I get here, and Bubba's got a whole new set of teeth.
Yeah, you like
it? I don't recognize him. He's got Hollywood hair, and he's wearing James Gregory clothes. Stardom just affects some people differently.
Yeah, I never thought
that chef pants would be considered an uppity move.
Yeah.
Now, I've worn those for a long time.
Yeah, chef pants.
Yeah.
You had a lot going until you got into his clothes. His clothes haven't changed much.
Yeah. I'm telling you, he's going to be quitting you pretty soon and running off with Kid Rock.
Let's get this out of the way. Those of you that love Tim Wilson, those of you that are intrigued by Tim Wilson, those you're just wondering about Tim Wilson, Nashville, Tennessee, he is on the way to see you as we speak. Zanies, you'll be there this weekend.
We'll be at Zanies tonight through Sunday. We are doing a heathen show Sunday.
Oh, wow.
So you could be out with your associate pastor improving yourself spiritually, or you could be sucking down a Budweiser listening to me. Sunday night. So it's tonight through Sunday at Zanies Comedy Club in Nashville, Tennessee. And I'm here basically... self-promotion.
You're hawking something.
I'm hawking something.
Look, there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, we hawk on.
Well, here, hand it to me. And I'll
handle it.
I'll handle the
hawking.
You're going to do it.
Tim, it was 3 years ago that Tim took me out to his stroke, and he said, I've got together with some legendary musicians and songwriters and singers, and I'm going to put together an all-star CD of the kind of music that I just enjoy. And I listened to it, and I told him how much I liked it. I wanted a copy of it. He wouldn't give me a copy of it. Said it's coming out soon.
That was 3 years ago. It was back when Bubba had Aniston helmet head.
Yeah. That far back.
And so now you put it together. But now, once again, this is one of the things in the entertainment business that sometimes we do, confusing the audience, thinking that Tim Wilson, this is a Tim Wilson comedy CD. It is not.
No, this is not a Tim Wilson comedy CD. Let me explain what this is. This is a bunch of songs that I like with my favorite singers. It's got Greg Allman on it. It's got T. Graham Brown on it. It's got Jimmy Hall from Wet Willie.
Oh, yeah.
It's got Levon Helm from the band. It's got Bobby Whitlock from Derek and the Dominoes. It's got Amy Helm, Mike Stewart, and Russell Smith from the Amazing Rhythm Aces.
Sitting at a tiny table in a ritzy restaurant.
And Ronnie Hammond from the Atlanta Rhythm Section.
How did you pull this off, Tim?
The contracts alone.
It's
how
what
did you
me and you
that?
Talk about all the time. God did it.
Oh, okay, good.
It was one of those deals where I asked God, and God sent me the people to do it, and they just sort of walked by my table. It was weird. Like Jimmy Hall, I was sitting there going, who am I going to get to be able to sing this People Get Ready song? And I look over at my manager,
pasta?
No, it was fettuccine Alfredo up there at the Trace in Nashville. Real good. So I'm sitting there eating.
We call that spaghetti where I'm from.
Well...
uppity spaghetti.
Yeah.
We call those James Gregory pants where I'm from. Anyway, so I'm sitting there eating, and Jimmy Hall walks by my table right as it came out of my mouth. And I went, boom, there's my guy. And I went over there and talked him into it. But my friend Steve Melton is my co-producer on this, and I mean he's the engineer, and he's sort of the and Melton and is a brilliant genius technically. He worked with Bob Dylan. He's worked with Bob Seger. He's worked with everybody. He's the man up in Muscle Shoals as far as engineering and producing and stuff. And they just opened a new studio up there called Big Daddy Rabbit is the name of that studio that just opened in Muscle Shoals yesterday.
You know, we're on there. We're on in Florence, Alabama. On the Big Dog.
You are?
Yeah.
Well, if anybody up there wants to do any kind of recording, go to Big Daddy Rabbit Recording Studio. It's right over there next to Fame. It's over there behind that McDonald's out there on that stretch.
Tim.
But as for Steve Melton.
So he's the genius. And Capitol Records.
He's the genius, and I'm the car salesman. I'm the guy who got everybody all the singers to show up. He got all the musicians to show up. And then we got in there and just kind of hashed it out over a period of about 2 years to.
It took three, Tim.
Well, it took a year to get it out.
Yeah.
This is Jimmy Hall doing People Get Ready.
From Street Corner.
He said, ooh, let me feel all right.
And this is his version of People Get Ready with you guys. And musicians, you put all this together, Tim? With you and I know Steve.
Well, me and Steve did, yeah.
Now, what cut is First Baptist Bar and Grill?
Now, listen to this.
People get ready.
Well, Willie.
There's a train of coming. Don't need no baggage. You just get on board.
How about he? I've always liked him.
Great singer.
To hear the diesel humming. Don't need no ticket. You just thank the Lord.
And you know, in the Radio Goob area, everybody has used his weekend song as their Friday kickoff thing.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Weekend, yeah.
Yeah, Johnny, coming on back. Weekend. 5 o'clock kickoff. Going to be playing your favorites on the way home. And so now you've got him in his element, though. I mean.
Yeah, Jimmy did that in one take. He's doing that with the band playing.
So yeah, that's just a live. Let's make the mics hot and let's rotate.
He's the most professional singer I ever met in my life. You walk in there, he had the lyrics written down on, not to that song, but on the Ramblin' Gamblin' Man, he had the lyrics written down on a legal
he
pad.
Does Ramblin' Gambling Man on there?
Does Ramblin'
Gambling
Man. Well,
cue that one up, Rick. I want to hear that
cue
one.
That up. Okay, all right. This one
now, how did Greg Allman feel about that? All these people in there together. Man, what a...
Oh, come on.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorites from Bob Seger, when he did his version.
Come on.
Great. Is this my copy?
Yes, sir.
I mean, I know you.
That is a great album. It's got. Put on number six.
Internet yet, or is it still too new?
Hopefully it's too new for them. This is what I say, Rachel.
T. Graham Brown singing this one.
Yeah, it's kicks butt. And Bobby Whitlock singing in the background with it. The guy from Layla.
Yeah.
Derek the Domino.
These are just like your favorite songs, and you brought all these
just
people.
Just some I thought would work for this.
Hey, mama, don't you treat me wrong. Come and love your daddy all night long.
Well, Tim, I love it. I'm a little hurt since you said I got 16 songs that I like and thought would work. Not one Mr. Lucky song on here. That's a little disappointing to us.
Well, it's because y'all grew up listening to all that Kiss crap and all that kind of stuff. What I was actually trying to go for here was about 1970 to
Man.
73 kind of feel to it. And
it's available everywhere, I guess?
You can get it at Walmart's. You can get it at Best Buy. You can get it at Tower Records. You can get it at Media Plays. And you have to look in the country section of various artists.
Well, how did
that
happen?
It's called All Night All Stars. What happens is anytime you put together a bunch of people, everybody gets all confused. And, oh, what are we going to do? Where are we going to put it? I thought, well, just give it its own little All Night All Stars thing in the record store. But everybody always panics and everything. So So you're going to have to look for it. You're going to have to get your acne face kit at your record store to get out from behind the counter and actually go help you look. But it's in various artists section of any Best Buy, Walmart, Tower, or Media Play, hopefully in America.
Greg Almald, name a few, Ronnie Hammond, as you mentioned, Amy Helm, Levon Helm from the band, Russell Smith, Mike Stewart, Bobby Whitlock, Kim Carmel, all featured on here, and there are a lot of covers, as you've heard, but also some original stuff, too.
Yeah, that album kicks butt. That's the best album made in Nashville, Tennessee last year.
All Night All Stars, look for it. Tim Wilson and Steve Melton put it out, along with these great artists that got together and said, yeah, we'll do a little jam session. Or it's basically a jam session of your dream.
Make it easy. Go to Walmart. Go to Amazon.com or Walmart.com and get the thing.
All Night All Stars. We'll be playing some cuts off it as we come back from the breaks. We'll come back more with Tim Wilson, and we have to discuss Bob the Bachelor last time. Tim, I know it's painful, but we have to. We'll be back.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
16 minutes past. From the CD, All Night All Stars, it shocks me that we ran through every way you could get this CD, and now we're still getting calls, where can you get it? Amazon.com, All Night All Stars, or you can get it Walmart, and most anywhere you buy CDs. Just look under various artists.
Especially Best Buy or Media Plays.
Yeah.
And just look under various artists in the country section.
Yeah, so All Night All Stars, and it has some classics on there. Now, Tim, I know that you have to indulge us. You're a working man, and you mainly work nights. So you're probably not familiar with the television series The Bachelor. Are you familiar with it at all?
Is this one of them ones where all the greedy girls show up and they're all fighting over some guy that don't deserve it?
Yes.
You may be talking about
variations.
Joe the Millionaire.
I've seen variations of the show.
Yeah. This is the original.
This is the one where they had The Bachelorette. She was picking guys, and there was this endearing at the time, overweight guy that we, of course, told the world she will keep him around because he's somebody who's so funny, and he's a good friend, but he will never get the girl.
Right.
Because the chunky, funny guy, what we had to fight our whole lives was being cast into the he's so funny, he's my friend mode.
Right.
Once that happens, you're done.
Yeah, you're over.
Yeah, so what they did him so much, they trimmed him down, which bothered me a little bit. Because I thought if they really wanted to make a statement, let's have a fat guy picking these girls.
Yeah, it wasn't like Jackie Gleason never, ever got late.
Right. And so they trimmed him down, and he came back, and he's looking Christopher Columbus. Sometimes with Tim, you just keep it moving, Chris. But it's a great point. And so, anyway, it got down last night. The two girls were left, and he had to pick one or the other. And as in true fashion with this show, they always pick the girl that the rest of us scream, don't pick her. And it happened
Bob
again.
Bob picked Estella, Beverly Hills mortgage banker.
Coincidence? I think not.
Rick, we were all pulling for the perky, very fun-loving Kelly Jo, who is actually from his home state, which you think that would make a lot in common. She now lives in Illinois.
I'm going to tell you what happened on this one.
Wait a minute. Did Bubba just say Illinois with an S?
Yes, I did. Much like you said Walmarts a minute ago.
I said Walmarts?
Yes.
Well, I meant Walmart's record various artists section.
Apostrophe S. Possession.
It's not Illinois. My brother says Illinois all
there
the time.
There he sits
My
right
brother
there.
Sitting over there, Tony Wilson.
Yeah, hey,
he always
Tony.
Says Illinois. Well, you went up there to Illinois. I go, it's Illinois, and it's salmon.
But why does it have an L? Why does Illinois have an S on the end?
Well, why does house have a U in it?
I agree.
Sure. English. That's easy to understand.
Yeah.
Sure. Well, it's not Selma, Alabama. It's Selma, Alabama.
Now you're about to get in a fight now.
Now I'm playing. Last night, I don't want to interrupt y'all's...
Illinois.
Oh, no.
I don't want to interrupt y'all's Bob the Bachelor thing.
I knew you weren't going to like it, and I told them we should wait, but the people want to discuss this. Look at the phones.
Well, I'll hush about salmon patties, and y'all talk about Bob the Bachelor.
Illinois.
Yeah. Anyway,
we always want to be factually correct. Tim.
I'm just glad that I didn't have to sit anywhere with you in that hairdo, Bubba, watching.
But anyway, on this show, let me tell you this is my prediction, because I think how good it is you'll meet somebody and you really like them, and it's because you haven't met the other person yet.
Yeah.
I think if this girl had got to meet his family first, Kelly Jo, that she would have won.
Her mom, or his mom, really threw things off with that. Kelly Jo didn't try to get to know me, which I don't know what that means.
Well, here's the problem.
Is that because she didn't walk through the woods with her? She walked through the yard with her dad.
Right. Now, you notice the dad, she was flirtatious with the dad, but what she made the mistake is, Bob is going to listen to what Mama says. Don't lose the fact on this show, Mama was in the game early. They brought her in to weed some people out early, so Bob will do what his Mama says.
I think his brother-in-law liked Kelly Jo better, too.
But the problem, and we said it early in the program, but it was off the air, the problem with going with what girl your Mama wants you to be with, your Mama's looking for a buddy, she's not going to make out with her. You know,
that's
so
right.
You really don't want your Mama making the choice on who you get, because anybody you can get through and get some PR with your mom, you know, but then you have to go and
live with them.
So that's
the
problem.
A couple of things, Rick. It was pointed out, we had joked about it when they had the reunion show, that Bob did not pick any blondes. Okay, he was not into the blondes.
Yeah.
Kelly Jo had a little bit of blonde go, and she was the closest to a blonde we had left. And Estella looks, almost a dead ringer, could be the sister of his ex-wife. They look extremely
alike. I've never seen a picture of her.
Well, just look at Estella, and that's pretty much her.
Well, let me say this. Bad call there.
I know. Why are you going down that road again?
If I beat that again.
Well, I'm back to what you were talking about letting your mama pick out a girl for you.
Okay? That's not
true. Trust me on this. Your mama's never going to go for the Mexican stripper. And that's the one that I'm looking for. You know what I'm saying? You know, there's who we're going to eat dinner with. And who are we going to go back in the bedroom with?
Yeah.
And mamas shouldn't have anything to do with anything past the bedroom door.
Yeah, I that's kind of what we're talking about. If you're going to marry this woman, you know.
Better known as living with her.
Yeah. Mama's gonna see her a few times a year.
Right.
You got a better chance of making somebody who mama doesn't like work in that small portion of your life than mama picking a girl you're going to hate the rest of your life, the other 90%.
You know where I thought, too, that Estella had blown it is when they were asking where they were going to live at.
Yeah.
And she was very vague because she's got her career out in, Hollywood. She's a mortgage,
Beverly
banker
Hills
person.
Mortgage consultant.
Better
known as Cold Fish.
Hey, she is not going to leave that job for Bob and the lake in Michigan. You know, it just ain't going to happen.
Well, there's a mistake right there. You don't ever marry anybody or go out with anybody expecting them to change on your behalf.
That's true.
You better like what you got because it ain't going to change.
Well, now, that's how the women,
That's the way it is. I was married to a woman.
For us, we want you to stay the same.
I tell you what, I was married to a woman. First off, she was an Israeli Jewish woman.
Yeah.
I was Leonard Skinner Baptist.
Yeah, that's...
Now, you can't go in there thinking I'm going to have her, going to see the Gospel of John with me.
Yes.
And all that kind of stuff. It ain't going to happen. Second of all, the loudest woman that ever lived. I was married to this woman for 14 years, and not one time did she ever have laryngitis. Yesterday, my daughter got in a truck. She had her tonsils swole up. I said, you must have got that from me, because your mother doesn't have that gene. Okay? And it never changed for 14 years.
Plus, she was a better shot than you.
She stayed Jewish. And she stayed loud. I mean, I'm talking about Ella Fitzgerald piercing the ears, busting ball jars and stuff,
Yeah. Did she stay on you, Tim? Is that what I'm hearing?
Oh, buddy. I guarantee you, this woman could chew rear end. I mean, I'd have the phone up the ear, and you'd think she was hollering at you, Bubba. You can still hear it. One time, this is how bad it was. One time, I was getting chewed so bad, I actually took the phone, put it down on the bed, went over to the bathroom, used the bathroom, came back, picked up the phone, and she was still going and didn't realize that it had been
going. Well, and you didn't even you set it up like a little CD player over in the corner. I mean, you could hear it fine.
Right.
Yeah.
So, but the thing is, I loved her, and I still love her a little bit, A little. I mean, I don't want to be married to her, but I mean, I love her. But you don't expect people to change. They're not going to.
But
it ain't going to happen.
But a woman's thinking is she thought she could change you.
Yeah, that's where she went in there thinking,
wives to stay just like they were the day we married them. And, of course, they want to change, but they think we're going to change, too.
Yeah, they think I'm going to drop this.
Right.
Hey, it ain't going to happen.
Yeah, and we think they'll never change that perfect hairdo that we thought they really looked good in.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But that that hairdo is going away.
Now, some of us are willing to change hairdos, aren't we, Bubba?
Well, this is only mine.
Some of us are willing to go get our teeth fixed, aren't we, Bubba?
Yes. What's Tim on me today? What is it?
I like the way he says, Bubba. We'll come back.
I'm on you, but I think it looks great.
We'll come back. We'll take phone calls and with expert commentary from Tim Wilson. He's at Zany's this week, tonight through Sunday night. So make plans in Nashville to go see Tim Wilson live on stage.
Rick and Bubba.
David Copperfield will be calling us. David Copperfield.
Yeah, but you called him the great David Copperfield. When I got here, I wasn't the great Tim Wilson.
Yes, you were. You didn't hear me mention
from the entertainment capital of the South.
Just because David Copperfield's a little more handsome than me and gets better looking women, has got more tigers and a bigger show, doesn't mean he's great.
David Copperfield joins us now. David, what's up?
What's up, man?
Hey, it has been a while since we have visited with you.
I know. How's it going?
I'm good. We understand, too, that you have removed all tigers from your act. Is that correct?
Never was in there.
I know. And you know what? And I think you stand vindicated today, sir.
David, we had a good time when you come by before. We enjoyed the fact that you made our producer, Speedy, disappear.
Yes.
And apparently you've done it again long distance because he's not here today.
I know.
David,
I can't say where he is, though.
David, you sound tired. Can I just say it? Is the road, has it got you wore down?
I'm road beat.
Yeah. Brother, hang in there. Your show.
I'm trying to sound sexy for all the women out there.
This is what you did. You do this on the show. You do this poor, pitiful David thing. The women flock to you at work before. And, you know, we are fired up that you're, you know, I know traveling around the country. I got an email last night. You know, we're in a number of markets that not only are you going to be in Birmingham coming up this week, but you'll be in Louisville, Kentucky, a big show coming up there as well. So our affiliate up in Litchfield, Kentucky said to be sure and remind everybody to check out all the dates of the David Copperfield show. Bigger and better than ever. Still enjoying it, except even though you sound tired today, David?
I don't sound tired. I'm really trying to sound sexy, and it's not working, I guess.
Yeah, well, you're on one of these digital phones.
Yeah, where are you at, David?
I have no idea.
David, life on the road.
We've been there, David.
Nobody else knows.
The digital phones were great technology because they felt like we could get a lot more people on.
Yeah.
But there's still just a hint of Darth Vader with them
if
it's not quite dialed in. So
especially if you breathe heavy.
I mean, right now, this could be my cousin calling.
And we couldn't even tell.
And there's no way I would know whether it was really you or not.
Well, I can tell you, your cousin sounds tired. I'm in Chattanooga, by the way. I'm Chattanooga, just so you know.
And it is him a note.
So now, David, I, the last time that you were in Birmingham, Alabama, and were on tour, all kidding aside, he took Speedy and I guess how many ever other listeners of the show, and made them all disappear. What have you got? Same type stuff going on this time, or any new illusions that have been added?
Lots of new stuff. I show you how it's possible to win the lottery.
You show us how it's possible to win the lottery. Everybody, take a note on that one.
Now, David, one of the things, too, we took Speedy and threatened to beat him up unless he told us how you did it. And how about this? He doesn't know how you did it.
Speedy is so cool.
No, he really did. He said, you know, guys, I know that right now y'all have me in this trash can and you're filling it up with worms.
Right.
And I would tell you, but I don't know what happened. I was just here and the next place I looked, I was somewhere else. So he's not tattling.
Okay, that's good. Save the trash can, though.
Yeah, I will. So can you go into how you show them how to win the lottery, or will we just leave it at that kind of tease?
Well, I have my grandfather's dream was to win the lottery and to win a dream car. Cars appear, motorcycles appear, I have a black African scorpion. I get a girl pregnant during the show. All kinds of new stuff. And well, I make people disappear, too.
That should sell a few tickets.
Let me tell you this. I mean, so this all happens without her knowing it? Because that's actually
unfortunately, that's kind of my normal routine.
Well, that's what I was about to say. That's exactly how I had my third child.
I thought we saw the video of that on the internet.
Hey, dating any big celebrity babes anymore, or you kind of got that dialed down?
No, my girlfriend is a private matter now.
Okay. Well, you know, can I tell you, David, that is...
But you know
she's more beautiful than all of them.
I start to say, you know she's got it going on.
Yeah, oh, sure. Well, I mean...
Because if she didn't, David would, do a trick and she'd have a new face.
I think Copperfield might have gone secret now with his relationships, which was the right thing. But he still showed us his bar.
what
I mean?
Sure.
Where everybody's being measured by. But anyway, so congratulations to you on that, David.
But here's a question for you. I got a question for you guys, okay?
All right.
When I'm in Birmingham, where should I take my girlfriend?
You know, I'm not trying to tell you what to do, But if you really want to bring her to town and really show her a good time, we wouldn't mind you taking her to Dreamland Ribs. And, you know, and y'all have some barbecue ribs. And we'd like to take you deer hunting this weekend. Dreamland Ribs.
Dreamland Ribs?
Yeah, it's a landmark in this part of the world. And funniest thing, when we go, ribs disappear. Yeah. And
And I don't want you to get overwhelmed with excitement, okay? Because I'm about to give you a real high and followed by kind of a low, okay? So be careful. I don't want to tamper with your emotions.
All right.
But the back up.
And we know how you lock those statues.
But the bad news is, they don't have the part ready for you to actually go and see it. So you have to look at it from your car.
Okay.
So just
don't miss that.
The Man of Steel is back up, and we'd like to see you come back maybe next year and make it disappear.
Where is it?
It's on the top of Red Mountain. You'll see it.
It's like the second largest statue in the world.
But he has no pants on. That's the part that's uncomfortable.
Yeah, if you don't mind a Roman god of fire overlooking your city, it's fine.
Right, yeah.
All right, I'll take your word for it.
So with your girlfriend, y'all going to eat Dreamland ribs, and then you're going to go see the Vulcan. And if you got some time, you know, Saturday, we'd love to take you deer hunting.
Take what?
Deer hunting.
Deer hunting.
Yes, hunting season opens this weekend, David. I know it's a little hard to fathom, but
we'd be happy to take you if you'd like to go.
All right, you got to talk to Pink about that.
Well, David, look, how many shows we got going this weekend? Should I ask someone?
5:30 and 8:30 at the Civic Center.
And that's Sunday night. Yeah, 5:30. And also another one at 7:30 at the Civic Center.
No. Let's get it right. 5:30 and 8:30.
Say, how was you gonna? Because the show's two hours long. And so 5:30 and 8:30, you get tickets to all the normal ticket locations. And y'all go out and show David Copperfield a lot of love. As you can hear, the poor man's he's on the edge of death. And,
I know this. If half his crowd's missing, they're all going to be at Dreamland Barbecue.
David, thanks. Y'all be careful.
See us next time you through town.
Yeah, and next time, get here early enough so you can hang out with us here on the air, because we really had a blast with that last time.
Hey, take care, guys.
All right, man. Thank you, David.
And
there's why we don't do phone interviews much.
Wow. Well, that was tough for us. How about y'all?
Look, I'm sweating. I was working so hard to pull anything out of David Copperfield. I wanted him to disappear.
See, now let me explain something to you.
But can I tell you something?
And this is from years of experience.
His show,
David did not want to do that.
No.
And I hated that he had to do it on our behalf.
Who forced him to do it? Forced him?
Hey, David Copperfield is arguably the greatest magician that ever lived.
Unbelievable.
And a highly handsome man.
Okay? Unbelievable.
If I was gay, he'd be on my list. You know what I'm saying? Highly handsome.
Yes.
But he ain't funny worth a damn. Okay? And what happens, though, and here's what happens. And here's what happens. He gets the real smoking girlfriend.
Right.
And he won't even take her to eat ribs. But he still gets the smoking girlfriend.
But hanging on to him's the key.
So, see, that's what we were talking about earlier. The guy who won't go to a barbecue place, don't know where the top of the mountain is, don't know what deer hunting is, and ain't funny worth a damn, ends up getting the good-looking woman. Why? Because she says, oh, he's got a great sense of humor. It means he'll laugh at stuff she says.
Right.
Well, you know,
it doesn't mean that he actually has a professional sense of humor.
Yeah.
He's just willing to laugh at the crap she says.
You're right.
Well, let me tell you what happened last time. He came in.
He was great.
He was very much like that when he got here last time, but he warmed up.
He warmed up.
We had a good time.
Right.
Hey, this is different from any show I've ever been on. I usually don't do radio. Hey, this is fun. And apparently he didn't feel that same way today.
Well, it's the phone. So
you're on a bus somewhere.
I love cell phones. They're very convenient. But you can't get a feel of what's going on.
And you feel like you're inviting yourself to somebody else's party.
Right. So, you know, man, we talked about
That's why I never do call-ins to the Rick and Bubba Show. Never
Thank
do.
Thank you, Tim.
Because Rick makes you feel like an idiot on the phone.
Yeah, because you know why? I'm dying. Did y'all feel me dying?
Yes. He could have had a whole bit lined up,
because
it's a phone.
Right, because it's a phone.
And
that's why I never call.
I don't even give anybody on the phone a chance. I'm so certain it's gonna bomb that I'm already ready for it to bomb. I'm very phone sensitive.
We should ask him if he watched Bob the Bachelor.
The self-fulfilling radio phone prophecy. You're so sure that it's going to stop.
Yes.
That you overdue to compensate.
You're right.
Well, no, guilty. Sometimes that might be the case. That one was doomed. There's nothing you could do.
I actually, be honest with you, Rick, I thought you pulled that one out. I thought you were the magician on the phone that time. Yeah.
Can I say this?
Anybody who can make that entertaining is a professional broadcaster.
I'm not sure I did, though. Let me say this. I'm going to rank this one, and you help me because you remember it maybe better than me and Dee. I'll need your help, too. The author of 1995. Was this worse? Remember that author we had?
No. That was worse.
Right, 1995. So is this number two?
I'm with Tim. I think we're probably being overcritical of it because we had such a good time last time. Because
he was great in the studio. He really was.
Well, first off, I'm positive David Copperfield's a nice man. I can tell by talking to him. He seems like a nice guy.
He is, and the show will absolutely blow you away if you've never seen it.
Right.
Unbelievable.
I mean, you're not going to be entertained. Let's put it this way. You know, I'd be embarrassed if you came to my show instead of going to see David Copperfield.
Yes.
Okay? David Copperfield's more expensive.
Right.
How much are tickets?
Oh, I'm sure they're up in the $50, $60.
Right.
And they are well worth it. They are well worth it. David Copperfield shows, it's like going to see Dagum Houdini. It's awesome.
I would say
he's alive.
I would say his guarantee for a show is somewhere on the size of venues he's going to. I would say his guarantee is probably $150,000 to $200,000
a night
to come. Yeah.
See, and his daddy's sitting around worried about hitting the lottery. If his son was worth a damn, he would send his daddy enough money where he wouldn't be thinking about the lottery.
You know, well, it's strange you said that amount, Rick. That's about what James Gregory gets, isn't it?
Yeah, probably. Sometimes. Well, sorry.
If he's got on those pants.
But look, again, I'm more confident than ever on why I don't like phone interviews.
But I tell you what, and I'm not just trying to suck up to you and blow smoke, okay? You pulled it out. And what did it was when you brought up Dream Lamb Barbecue.
Well, Bubba was giving me signals. That's the only place we had to go.
Well, you figured out a way to put David Copperfield and Dream Lamb Barbecue together, and that's funny.
We're back 13 minutes to the top of the hour. Tim Wilson is our guest. Tim's at Zany's in Nashville this week, Thursday through Sunday night. He also has put together a CD that we will love, featuring Greg Almond, Graham Brown, Jimmy Hall, Ronnie Hammond, Amy Helm, Levon Helm, Russell Smith, Mike Stewart, Bobby Whitlock, Kim Carmel. The list is on and on. Some great rock and roll classics along with a few originals. It's called All Night All Stars, and it's available wherever you get CDs, so check it out wherever you pick yours up. Tim, we do have callers standing by talking about a number of topics. So,
hey, Rick, just quickly, I want to mention the part of the White House was evacuated a few minutes ago due to an emergency situation. It seems that an aircraft flew into the restricted zone or the restricted airspace around the White House, although there was no problem. Apparently, it was just an accident that they got over in that space. We've had about three or four of these,
right.
And it's pretty clear. It's marked on all the aeronautical maps. Stay clear of that. If they would shoot one of these Cessna sightseers down, I guarantee you they'd get out of the area.
That would get the message across, don't you think?
We'll keep waiting and wait too long on one that's, up to something. So, there again, another good one flying through there.
Tim, you went with the hat now.
Happened is I was sitting around picking on Bubba's hair, and then I looked over at the monitor and saw this. This is when I get this going. Because I got about 12 hairs hanging on right here.
Right.
There's 12. I've named these 12. That's Leon right there. if I ever get to heaven, I'm going to find a hair angel and whip his butt. So I decided I'd go back out and get my General Custer uniform, which is just the way I dress when I...
To me, you look more like Billy Jack.
Yeah.
Billy Jack, I'm going to put this foot on that side of your face, and there's nothing you can do about it.
You know, he looks like that lawyer that defends all the wackos.
Yeah.
That wears that jacket every time.
That guy's old.
Yeah. Well, Jerry Spence has got white hair, but if I had white hair, I'd kind of look like Jerry Spence.
You would.
And I like to argue about as much as Jerry Spence.
Yes, you do.
So I think I'm going to just be the young Jerry Spence.
My favorite thing, anytime I run into anybody that knows you, I go, you just can't get Tim to give you his opinion on anything. And I just start laughing hysterically. that's when I know they really know you. You know what I mean?
The other day I was walking in some place and this little 16-year-old girl jumps up and goes, "Look, Mama, it's Neil Young."
You do
it's
like
the sideburns.
Let's go to Angie in Chattanooga, Tennessee, where David Copperfield's bus was just rolling through. Angie, welcome to the show. How are you?
Hi, great. Monkey Grass.
Hey, thanks for calling. We appreciate that.
Love you guys. This just goes to show Bob the Bachelor.
Yes.
Talking about Bob the Bachelor.
Yes.
This just goes to show how fickle men can be.
How fickle we can be?
Exactly. Not all men.
Right.
Bob the Bachelor. I'm talking about Bob the Bachelor only. Kelly Jo, for him.
Well,
he missed it.
You know, and
why can't guys see that?
Well, you know, it seems so obvious when, you know, it's all edited and you get to watch.
And I thought Kelly Jo did. Well, you didn't wear this outfit right. She went back. She got that bathing suit on again on that last visit.
Yes, she did.
You know, she would go that two-piece pretty quick, which I thought she got good points for that.
Wore the right dress.
Good-looking red dress at the end, you know, with the, you know, the back show. That was a good, that was a good pick.
Estella was trying to get him to, you know, give her some answers before he made his choice or as he was making his choice. Kelly Jo didn't do that.
I'm going to tell you that she looked like his ex-wife. He is just into the dark hair, tall and light complected look, and she was. I mean, that was it, Rick. You got to.
Well, you know,
I don't want anybody that looks like my ex-husband.
Well, here's the thing too. You got to remember, Bob doesn't really want to get serious with anybody. I mean, he gave her a 2-carat friendship ring. Anybody said, let's just see how this goes. I want you to wear this on your finger just in case.
I think he made a mistake too, Rick, because now when he actually. If he does want to propose to her, she ain't going to accept just putting it on the other hand. Is the way. I mean, you got to have more jewels,
that's right.
In.
Yeah.
You know, that's
he actually they give him an engagement ring, and they if they want to propose, they can propose. He didn't propose, but he said, "I want you to wear it anyway."
On the right hand as a friendship ring.
Do y'all notice y'all are having to explain everything on this show to me?
I know, Tim, and I
why? Because there's no way in hell I would watch this show.
I know, Tim, and I'm sorry about that. And we don't watch it either. When's the grand finale next week?
Well, they're doing an after the ring show, Rick. First time that we're going to have a locker room report.
Yeah, let's go to Marvin in Scottsboro, Alabama.
Marvin.
Yeah, I got two things, guys. One, Tim, you are possibly one of the funniest men I've ever seen in my life.
Well, we got to get you out more, Marvin. Where is Marvin? Where are you?
Scottsboro, Alabama.
Scottsboro, Alabama? Well, I'm sure there's a lot of people funnier than me in Scottsboro. There's a guy over there. Is Scottsboro is between Chattanooga and Huntsville?
Yes, that's it.
Or you turn left in there.
Right, yeah.
Well, there's a gas station out there. Right before you turn left to go to Scottsboro, there's a guy funnier than me in that gas station over there.
What was your second thing, Marvin?
And two, Rick, I got to apologize. That wasn't David Copperfield. That was my cousin that called.
Thanks, Marvin. Let's go to...
David Butterfield.
Let's go to Duff, Jacksonville, Alabama. Duff.
Hello, guys. Hey. Good to talk to you.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, it's Duff Manners, the walking, talking legend from Jacksonville, Alabama.
It's me. It's Ernest, too. That's
Jacksonville, Alabama? My daddy played football at Jacksonville Teachers College back in the 40s before it turned into the university.
Yeah.
My daddy actually started in the second football game he ever saw in his life in Jacksonville, Alabama.
Duff, go ahead.
Well, I just wanted, you know, last night we didn't watch this Bachelor thing at
all.
Well,
we shouldn't be watching
night.
It.
No,
yeah.
Us either.
And then we watched it last night, and I just think that girl took some notes from Helene. And I think what's his name was the young man Bob there, if he was as gun-shy as everybody was saying he was, he should have took some notes and watched, and then maybe he'd have figured out who he should have gone with.
I give them another few months, max, after they've done their PR tour, and the friendship ring will get hawked at some pawn shop. And I'm going to tell you what I wanted to see, and I really thought she was the best choice of all the Bachelors that's been on. I really thought there was a chance with her being very similar to my wife, you know, the very athletic, you know, feisty approach, that she would be the one to slap Bob right there, right in front of the swimming pool.
Oh, she wasn't happy.
No.
She didn't go out very graceful, which I love.
Yeah.
I wish she had hit him, wouldn't you? Wouldn't that have been great?
It would have been great TV. I mean, because this is all this is about anyways, entertainment. Let's try to talk her into maybe pushing him in the pool or something. That would have been great.
Down that cliff behind
him. Oh, yeah. TV, I know you leave us now. Don't forget Tim Wilson, Nashville, Zanies. Tonight, you... CD he's got out, All Night All Stars. Look for it wherever you pick up CDs. If you have another hour still to come.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.